you, Patriots. Today is a marvelous, mindful Monday morning, November 8th.
I don't know about you, but I'm feeling a bit tired today. It was hard to get out of bed, and my brain is a little slow after staying up all night reading.
I bet Mrs. Keene can help. A little mindful breathing.
Hey, Patriots. This is Mrs. Keene with Mindful Monday, and today we're going to be doing an activity that involves using your brain, your breathing, and your fingers. Did you know that your fingers are directly connected to your brain? Your fingers have the most nerve endings out of anything in your body. So when you're feeling things with your fingers, it sends lots of signals to your brain, and that could help distract your brain when it has flipped its lid and your amygdala takes over and you are really emotional. So doing this activity could help reset your brain so that you can focus. So the activity is called Finger Fiddle. And so we are going to be making brain-body connections by using our fingers. When you exercise your fingers, you also exercise your brain too, which could help you to focus. So let's get started. So the first thing I want you to do is take your fingers and you're going to put them together like this and press. And we're going to take a deep breath in and out. Make sure you fill up your lungs good before you let that breath out. Just do it again. In, out. And now every time we take a breath, I want you to tap your fingers 4 or 5 times while we're breathing in, and then go move to the next finger to tap your fingers 4 or 5 times as we're breathing out. Looks like this. Breathe in and out. In, out. In, out. And now I want you to try to do it, but not keep your fingers touching. So we're going to breathe in and out. In and out. See if you could do it with your eyes closed. Breathe in and out. In and out. If you're breathing and you're tapping your fingers, then pay attention to how it feels when you're tapping your fingers. Are you tapping them soft? Are you tapping them hard? How does it feel when they come into contact with each other? Because that's another part of mindfulness, is really feeling what's going on as well as that breathing. So I hope that you practice your tapping and your fingers if you ever feel like you need to distract your brain so that you can turn it back on to focus. And I hope you have a mindful Monday.
Thanks, Mrs. Keene. This will be helpful throughout this week.
Let's talk about lunches. Today for lunch, we are having PB&J to-go box, cheese snack combo, crispy chicken bites, crispy chicken drumsticks, or Eggo G waffles.
Vegetable and fruit choices are celery dippers, potatoes, fresh oranges, peach cup, or juice. And don't forget your milk and utensils.
I think there's some Patriots having a little more to their lunch today. Cake! It's birthday time! Today's birthdays are Mason R. in Ms. Prince class and Ariana T. in Ms. Smith's class. Happy birthday!
Wednesday is an early release day. Remember, we leave 2 hours earlier. Well, not you teachers, but enjoy your 2 hours kid-free.
This Thursday, November 11th, is our Veterans Day celebration. We are all going to gather out in the courtyard at 10 a.m. We will honor those who have served in our military by saying the pledge, singing our national anthem, and by signing, I'm proud to be an American.
Make sure you are practicing this week. Stand up and sign along during the snow show.
Teachers, Mrs. Harris is looking for students who can help on Thursday, leading us all in signing. Be on the lookout for role model signers in your class.
Well, Patriots, that wraps up our news show for today. Please stand for the pledge led by Mrs. Schmidt's class and a moment of silence and to sign proud to be an American.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Living the questions
by feeding our passions
and exploring our wonders. Bye.
Bye.